I want to respond to some of your comments, and I also want to talk about how I spend my weekends. I also want to show you a little bit of how I spend my weekends. I also want to talk about some things that are going on in the world. First, monkeypox. Some people are concerned about that. News articles are popping up all over the place talking about the spread of this monkeypox. From my understanding, monkeypox is mostly spread through physical contact. It can be spread respiratory, that route, but usually you have to be really, really, really close to the person. And it's mostly sexual contact and some type of physical contact. It's spreading primarily through male-to-male sexual contact at this point. I don't think it's going to be another pandemic where they actually shut down the economy, shut down all these businesses and stuff like it was before. But some people are concerned about that. So I want to hear your perspective on that. Okay. Yeah, I got to get to the range a lot more. Some people were sort of critical of that story about that good Samaritan, that armed Samaritan who shot mass shooter, active shooter. Some of you guys don't really believe that 40-yard story. I gotta say, if he's able to hit 8 out of 10 times at 40 yards, that's pretty impressive, because I went to the range. I practiced at like 73 feet. Just at 73 feet, just to see where I was at. I barely hit the paper. I missed the target. I hit it once, but I mean, so yeah, I'm definitely not that guy. But I do wonder if it was actually 40 feet, because if you tell me 40 feet, that's something, like, I wouldn't even try a shot with a pistol that far out at 40 yards, you know. 30 or 40 feet is sort of getting into the range where I might be effective, but maybe I just need to go to the range a lot more. I am practicing more. That's something I'm doing. But I don't know. What do you guys think about that? Because somebody said maybe Hitchcock 45, maybe he could pull that off. Yeah, John D. said that. Bendover said that. It definitely wasn't 40 yards. Well, I don't know. A lot of you guys want to see the video of that, and I definitely understand that. John D. also said, I should learn Spanish as the fastest growing demographic, especially in Texas. Yeah, I mean, the sensible thing for me to do would be to learn some Spanish. You know, it could benefit me as far as my career. That makes more sense. It's something I'm going to have to do. I'm going to have to learn a little bit of Spanish. But right now, the German is just something I want to brush up on, because I took a couple classes in college, and I enjoyed it. You know, I had to choose a foreign language, so I decided to go with German because my last name is German. And when I showed up to class, I said my name is Kegler. And the German professor let me know that the K-A-I, meant that it was actually pronounced Kegler, not Kegler. So that's the day I learned how to pronounce my name. But sort of funny. But yeah, so that's a sensible thing to do, learning Spanish. At one point, I would have said Mandarin. I appreciate your support, guys, on noticing my weight loss journey. It's something I should have done years ago. Somebody asked me, what type of retention do I have in my holster? It's just your typical Kydex holster. It's nothing special. So it's just something I want to talk about. How do I spend my weekends? I'm going to the gym every day. That's something that I'm doing every day. Sometimes on weekends, I go a couple times a day because I don't have a lot else going on. I went to the movies recently. I saw Nope. Nope. It's a Jordan Peele movie. And I was in the theater, and there was like four or five obnoxious teenagers. And this is becoming a common theme. They were making noise. They were talking. Yeah. But here's the worst part. They were more interesting than the movie. You know, they were more interesting to me than the movie. So the power goes out and the movie shuts off. They say, "Oh, we're gonna get it going." After 10 minutes or so, the movie comes back on, and they started up at a place that we've already seen. So I'm like, okay, everybody's like, we already seen this. And I left. I mean, that's just how I feel. It wasn't just so much the kids, really, because one thing these exhibitors have to understand is that, you know, with Netflix, Hulu Plus, Paramount Plus, and Disney Plus, and all this stuff, HBO Max, with all these great options at home, you really need a really good movie to really get people to go out to the theaters and deal with all the BS, you know. I guess I could have stood up and told them, hey, be quiet, but yeah. It's just something that I don't know. It just might just be easier. I did see Thor recently. Thor, Love and Thunder. What a weird movie. The best way I can describe it is cute. Cute. Not really particularly good. It was just, it was tolerable for 2 hours, I guess. It was tolerable. But giving those kids superpowers or whatever, it just seems kind of, felt like a kid movie at one point. It just, I wonder what people think about Americans across the world when they see some of these goofy movies, because Top Gun was awesome. But it seems like we're only going to get movies like Top Gun like once or twice a year. Like, I don't know. Maybe there might be like 5 or 6 movies throughout the entire year worth actually seeing. I saw this other movie called X. It's a horror movie. And, you know, when I saw that elderly woman undress, that was a movie I just walked out of. But anyway, when I went to see, what was I talking about? Nope. Yeah, I just left. I just left. I didn't even see all the movie. I don't know. I'm just getting to the point where I just can't do it anymore. Yes, I'm going through the comments right now. And some good news with Kaliningrad. Lithuania basically backed off of that situation. Remember, they closed down the rail system, so Russia didn't have access to to Kaliningrad. They backed off of that a while ago. I'm glad, because I was sort of concerned about that escalating into a really bad situation. Recently, at Odessa, there was some type of attack. Russians are telling Turkey that they had nothing to do with it. We don't know what's really going on there. We may never have the truth. Oh, somebody recommended something called something made by the clothing arts, khaki pants or travel pants. I might check that out. They're kind of expensive, but you know, and that's another thing with clothes. As I'm losing weight, I got to decide at what point do I want to start buying new pants? Because right now the 40s I'm wearing from 5'11", they're way too big. If I don't wear a belt, they just fall right off. I'm wearing 38 jeans now from LA Police Gear. That's fairly comfortable. There's still some space in there. So I need to, I'm planning on waiting until I get down to like a 36. I don't know. I might be able to get into that right now. I want to get into like a 36 by 30 and then start buying new clothes, because, you know, that, I don't want to buy some stuff at 38 and then I get a little bit smaller. And then I'm like, oh man. Now I got to buy new clothes, so that could get kind of expensive. So that's something I'm definitely keeping my eye on. Oh, here's an article that really interests me. More Americans are working second jobs as inflation rages. So during the pandemic, it was somewhere around 4% of the employed people holding multiple jobs in the U.S. According to the St. Louis Federal Reserve, by June of this year, that figure increased a full 1% point. So I don't know. Are you guys working a second gig to sort of keep your family above water? Is that something that you guys are doing? Because for a while, people turned to credit cards, a lot of credit cards, sort of bail themselves out of this situation. And more people are finding themselves having to work that second job. So how concerned are you about this monkeypox? How concerned are you about maybe COVID becoming a bigger thing and there's more lockdowns? Maybe there might be a more deadlier strain that may pop up. you know, at this point, I don't know how people would even react to that. I mean, I see another article. NBC journalist laments, quote, "People don't trust us. They don't believe us," end quote. Well, yeah. Like, my only question is, who in the heck still trusts the mainstream media? I'm really interested in that. Like, what is wrong with you that you actually trust these people? I'm not saying they're all, well, I just don't have any faith in them, any trust in them. I know I'm bouncing all over the place. I still want to go back to entertainment. Yeah, I finally watched this movie on, what was it, Amazon Plus or no? Yeah, it was Amazon Plus or was it Netflix? Netflix, yeah. It's called The Gray Man. It's actually pretty decent. There's some good stuff on streaming, you know, The Terminalist on Amazon Prime, awesome. Reacher also on Amazon Prime. Amazon Prime is really good at those action thrillers, but they're terrible at fantasy. You know, is when they avoid the political correctness, they had that, they do really, really well. But anyway, these are just some of my random thoughts, some quick look at some of the things I do on the weekends. Tell me, how do you spend your weekends? Have you changed the way you spend your weekends because of inflation? Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.